All of mankind share one thing in common, and that is we are all born with the sin nature. Paul, in the fifth chapter of Romans, says, "Wherefore, as by one man sin entered the world, and death by sin, and so death passed upon all men, for that all have sinned." We are all corrupted with the sin nature, and as such, we all deserve death and hell. But God, through his infinite wisdom, provided the way of escape, and that is the Lord Jesus Christ and what he did for us at the cross. Welcome to my program. This is a Bible study called Victory at the Cross. The subject of this study will be regarding the sin nature of mankind. Now, all of mankind is corrupted with the sin nature. The Bible tells us that there is only one solution to our problem, and that is the Lord Jesus Christ and what he did for us at the cross. This is segment one of our sin nature study, and we will be studying out of the book of Romans, primarily in chapters 6, 7, and 8. Men are sinners by birth and practice. Sin is universal, and man's history bears out the apostles' words in Romans chapter 1, verses 18 through 32. Sin must be judged by God, and his judgments are right. Romans chapter 2, verses 1 through 29. But God does not delight in judgment. His delight is in saving the sinner from sin and the consequences of it. Romans chapter 3, verses 9 through 31. Through Jesus Christ, God has provided a way whereby man, evil though he is by nature and practice, may stand before him, clothed in the righteousness of Jesus Christ. Romans chapter 3, verses 21 through 26. For a man, however, to be justified before God does not exhaust all that God has done for him. Salvation is the great inclusive word of the gospel and includes, to mention only a few, 1. The forgiveness of sins. 2. Being declared righteous before God. 3. Receiving the new birth and the new life in Christ. 4. The redemption of the body. And the list goes on and on. It is no wonder that as Paul contemplated the great sweep of salvation, he cried out, "For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believeth, to the Jew first, and also to the Greek." The first five chapters of Romans not only show that salvation is needed and provided, but toward the last part of the fifth chapter, the groundwork is laid for the subject of the victorious life in Christ. Adam bequeathed to his posterity a sin nature with all its evil desires and death. Christ, on the other hand, through grace, provides life and deliverance from the sin nature and victorious living, for we read, "For if by one man's offense death reigned by one, much more they which receive abundance of grace and the gift of righteousness shall reign in life by one, Jesus Christ." Romans 5:17. Up to the time of our salvation, we were under the domination of the fallen nature. But when Christ saved us and became our life in us, he made it possible for a new kind of behavior, a new kind of practice on our part. How that victory over sin is to be achieved, and how our daily walk may be made pleasing to God, is the subject of Romans 6, 7, and 8. Many of God's people, when asked how they are progressing in the Christian life, will answer, "I am still living in Romans 7. By that, they are thinking of Paul's experience when he said, "For the good that I would, I do not. But the evil which I would not, that I do." Romans chapter 7, verse 19. They forget, however, that that was only a temporary experience with Paul, not a permanent one. The Christian life to many believers seems to be a series of ups and downs. They try to do a good thing and find they cannot. Then they try not to do some evil thing, and in spite of everything, find themselves doing it. The problem arises from the fact that they have not fully realized and consequently have not appropriated all that Christ has done for them as believers. The foundation truths for a victorious, peaceful, happy Christian life are laid down in Romans 6. We may face trials on every hand and yet have quietness and confidence in the heart. We will never be without testing and trials on this earth, but we can come through them as victors. There are some who will protest and say, "You do not know the circumstances under which I have to live." Well, but the truth is, no circumstances can win out over the victory that God provides. The Lord Jesus walked upon the waters when the storms were raging on the sea. In a spiritual sense, even though storms may be raging in our lives, we can walk on top of the boisterous waves with our hearts at peace, victorious over all circumstances. This is possible only as we comprehend, through the help of the Holy Spirit, these basic truths laid down in Romans 6. Another name for the victorious life is the sanctified or separate life. The sanctified life is not a matter of feelings. We thank God for feelings. They are necessary, but they are not reliable proof in themselves with regard to the true state of the Christian life. The word sanctify means to separate, and it is the life of separation from sin unto Christ, which is the subject of Romans chapters 6, 7, and 8. If we get the foundation laid properly for this truth, then we will find ourselves growing little by little. We must not become discouraged if we do not see all of this truth at once. We will find, as Paul did, that there are obstacles in the way. We will also find that as we come to understand more fully this doctrinal aspect of the life of victory, we will experience more victory from day to day. Before we take up these matters in more detail in later segments of this series, there are two facts that we should keep in mind constantly. One is our fallen nature, or the flesh nature. There is no good thing in it. We cannot change it for the better. There is no improving it. It will always be at enmity with God and the things of God. The other fact to keep in mind is that there is forgiveness in Christ for the sins we commit. Now, there is no excuse for sin in our life, but it does happen. Our Savior stands ready to forgive our sins if we will but confess them. 1 John 1:9. When Jesus died for our sins, he died for all of them. He anticipated every one of them and bore the penalty in his own body on the tree. Now to recap, our victory is in Jesus Christ and in what he did at the cross. The sixth chapter of Romans gives the foundational doctrine. The seventh chapter shows this life put to the test. And the eighth chapter reveals how victory is won through the power of the Holy Spirit in the life. Thank you for watching.